randomized. We're going to hear from Team Fitness first, followed by Whack the Six Pack, and then finally AI Consulting will be the last team. Each team will have exactly 10 minutes to present. They will be cut off. Dr. James Brown will serve as our moderator. That will be followed by approximately 5 minutes of Q&A from the finalist judges, and only the finalist judges, okay? And once the Q&A ends, then the second team will come up, log into their presentation, and then when they're ready, we'll begin. They've got exactly 10 minutes. Dr. Brown will moderate the time, and you'll have about 5 minutes of Q&A. Make sure that when you answer questions, you understand the question, repeat the question, and provide short, impactful, concise answers, right, to maximize your time. And so for those of you that are going to be in the room, now I'll ask that you please stay in the room. All right? Without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's give this team a round of applause. Our first team.
Everything nowadays is advancing so quickly. update, you know, a month later. It needs to be current with everything else going on. Next one is legal. So we will need to monitor minimum wage and overtime legislation currently, or that is currently going on. And then there is a health savings act legislation that is pending at the moment. It allows gym memberships, equipment, and programs to be tax deductible. So we feel like this will encourage people to sign up for gym memberships. And lastly, we have environmental. So we want to be mindful of our energy use. We want to obviously follow pollution laws. We want to use environmentally friendly cleaning solutions when it comes to cleaning all of our equipment. We want to make sure that we are recycling. All right, so fitness came to us with a problem. They were not bringing a profit and they were not growing their market. They had a net profit of -$15,144, which is not good. So we were hired to kind of help bring them out of the ditch. We assume that they already have an employee base and they have a member base already made up of active and inactive members. Some symptoms and barriers to entry include member participation at an all-time low and low advertising budget, which obviously is not looking about. So the stakeholders we want to be mindful of, because we have our members, we want to make sure that they're getting what they're paying for. We have the bank who's investing money in us. We want to make sure that they're making that income back, they're not losing money, and that the owners who have invested their time and money and also gain from this investment. And now we'll be able to talk to you more about HR processes.
Thank you. So for HR processes, we first want to see who do we want to hire, what kind of people do we want to work with us. And first, if we want an inclusive base for our gym, we would like empowering staff and a competitive environment. So we want to be able to push ourselves to be able to do better, but hold each other to higher standards so that we can actually get to our goals. For management, we would like to focus on our leaders, because your team is only as strong as your leader. So here we want someone with experience in the physical fitness industry, not so much management, but does have those leadership skills, which is why we would focus internal first. So if we do have somebody within our company who is exemplifying great leadership skills but doesn't necessarily have management in their background, we would be more than willing to teach them the tools they need to be able to grow within our company. As well as the compensation, we're going to be very competitive. And we would start at a $34,000 base salary, as well as offering health and dental and a 401k plan. And it also applies to our team. We want to start with external recruiting. We're looking at LinkedIn, Indeed, Handshake, looking at a lot of our college students in the area, as well as employee referral programs so that we can maintain the culture within our employees. And internal advancements, so we're giving our staff the potential to grow. And our CRM software that we decided to use is Zoho. And with Zoho, we're able to track time, week, and attendance all in one easy, concise, easy to use and concise program. And the second service that is very handy for us is an employee performance review. And with that, we're able to track our growth, needs of improvement, and see how our employees are doing over time in new positions. And now, Brandon will tell us about fitness, or finances.
So the first thing, I just want to a couple key financials. Take over. The first one is the net income by year, which of course starts out negative, and we projected to get to $13,000 the third year. And this is assuming a 30% sale increase in the first year and 40% in the second year. The second thing was 4-week programs, which were specialized in HIIT classes. So right now they have $23,000 in sales, and we're looking to up that up by about $27,000. And this is because we're looking for more of the age group of 36 to 44. We're hoping that about a 50% increase, because this is the baby boomer children group, which a lot of them are getting into fitness right now. And then the last one was gym monthly memberships, which make up the majority of our sales as gyms. And we're hoping that this increases 30% in both years, because 20 members per month. And then we're going to look at total operating expenses, which will stay relatively the same, very low and inexpensive. That's because Bolt will be the app that's actually, the charges are put into the membership for our customers. And then also Zoho will just be the only thing that we're going to be really changing in the operating expense. So that's why you see the jump from the $1,000 and the $2,000 last year. And then the labor costs, we're assuming that the staff will stay the same. So as you can see, labor costs will stay the same until the third year, which is when we can start assuming that we're going to have a bigger gym, have more people come in, and that's when our culture is really changing. So some market research should be found that sales do make up 68% of most of all gyms' sales. And the second highest is personal training and mentorship classes, which we are focusing on a lot. And this is a breakdown of all the sales structure for each. gym and fitness centers. And then also, we looked up on MarketLine that in 2018, the growth for fitness and gyms was 3.5%, and it's looking to increase by 16.1% by the year 2023. And here's a graph of the past 5 years showing a growth trend of health and fitness. And finally, I just want to finish with a quote from IBISWorld, and it says, over the 5 years to 2023, revenue is forecasted to grow at an annualized rate of 1.1% to $35.3 billion as more customers purchase individualized health plans that include trainers, nutrition guidance. And what we do is, like, we're taking all those classes and our app, and we're trying to focus on the future, and that's really what everyone else is trying to focus on, too. So thank you for listening to us. We're Team Fitness. If there are any points that require further clarification, we'll take them now. If not, thank you.
Now start the 5 minute period for questions.
So a lot of our sales are, like, you mean like based off sales from gym memberships?
From your employee, no, from your actual employee standpoint, what are you doing to improve your employee? Like, what's their sale? Like, how are you improving the sales people themselves?
So we're going to be offering different training, like we said, with investing in our employees and trying to help them internally grow as well. So we're offering training classes on sales as well as, like, with Zoho and Bolt, just to give them the ability to be able to represent our company the best way.
And then they would start as hourly.
Starting out from a negative number, so it's going to be a lot of time, and there's still a lot of cost to go into fixing the whole culture program and hiring and stuff, so we're assuming we're not going to make too much money in the first couple of years.
Shoot, love, open high.
How did you get the 30% and 40% sales?
Those are assumptions made for if we develop our marketing right and we get 20 people per month, and our marketing's all doing that job, and that's what we assume that they're
doing.
Industry standard, I think, is for a sale, for increase, I mean, growth was at 3.5% for the overall market. But individually, I think it was about 25%.
Okay. Just inside.
Yeah.
Can you talk about retention again? What's your plan around retention? Because I think now, I mean, the numbers kind of shift. Typically, as many people are joining as that many people are dropping out on the other end. So can you talk again about retention?
That's totally fair, because we all know the gyms, people do tend to like drop off the radar. When it comes to retention, we tend to use the mentorship program for that. And when you join as a member, you actually get paired up with an instructor of a class or another manager, and they help like kind of guide you along and encourage you to continue the classes and create that bond so that we keep that retention.
And that's a free service.
Yes.
And how long does that last?
As long as you're a member.
Someone for them to go for questions.
And is trainers and are the trainers and the sales folks the same people?
Yes.
Okay. What's the hierarchy of the general manager from a manager standpoint and staffing standpoint?
So we would have a general manager, and then we have a manager of operations, a manager of membership, a manager of fitness, and then a manager of classes.
All right, that is 5 minutes of questions. Give my hand.
Looking into the business climate research, I want to point out four main points here. The first one is economics. So we have a growing industry. We have 59 million gym memberships in 2018, and moving forward, right underneath that, the social cultural lifestyle is that fitness lifestyle. You can have anywhere from a niche gym, or you can have like an LA Fitness or a Planet Fitness where it's a generalized lifestyle. Technology, moderately paced, again, remember that one. And then the last one there, environmental. High utility bills for this industry just because they're growing so much power to power all these machines. Moving forward, fitness just got spiked. So imagine you're going into a cycle class, and it's your normal class, however, the lights are off. It's like a club in there. You pick your team, and I want to be red team. So I pick my team, I type on my cycle, and I'm powering with my friends, and while I pedal, the machine is actually powering the facility by storing your energy and batteries. And then furthermore, your team score is projected up on screen as these lights and music is flashing, and you're competing against the other colors. We're gonna have local bar sponsored Friday and Saturday night evenings. This is where that social interaction comes from. You work out hard to win, you use our nice clean facilities to shower up afterwards, and then you enjoy discounts at the sponsored bar location for that evening. So Friday night evening, you get to go out with your friends right after your workout. And finally, the winning team for each evening gets a discounted beverage at our local smoothie bar and our spike bar. Moving forward into some sibling analytics on based on your location, I want to point out some cool things here to you. This is the alcoholic beverage sales away from home around St. Petersburg. Pay attention to those dark colors. Moving forward into the next one, we have some lifestyle statements, attitudes, and opinions. I work out regularly. Again, pay attention to those dark spots. We have two that we're matching. And then finally, our target age group, which is those tan colors. We want the lower age groups here. We're looking at college students. In this area, we have two prime college campuses. We have University of South Florida and the University of Tampa. Carrying forward into the party, Angela and Kwasi.
So let's get this party started. So at Spiked Up Fitness, we don't just cycle here. We also have other things that make this gym quite unique. For example, our bikes offer two different tiles style classrooms. So we have the classrooms that are more traditional, where you have an instructor powering the class to keep moving forward. And then you also have an individual room where, let's say you miss the class time and you just want to get your workout on, you can plug your smartphone into your Toronto-looking bike and get your workout on. We also have something very cool called the smoothie bar. And the smoothie bar is where we're going to spike up those smoothies on the weekends. So it is a start to your day. You're going to have a smoothie in the morning, or it's a smoothie at night, but you're going to spike up a little bit. Either way, you can do it. And the other thing is that we're fostering that environment that encourages social interaction. So in this day and age, a lot of people are online and they're not really interacting with people anymore. So this lounge would be a great spot for people to connect if they enjoy their team members. Everybody wants to know the cost. Well, we have a monthly subscription option or pay per use. The monthly subscription means that you can register for classes ahead of time and say that there's an instructor that fills up faster. Well, no problem. You can make sure you sign up ahead of time. And that would be just $34.99 a month with the initial fee of $99. Or you have the pay-per-use. Maybe you're not in the gym yet, maybe you don't know what this is, you have a friend coming to town, it's only $5 for one of these classes, so anyone can afford it. Marketing. Social media is going to be a huge thing for us. Specifically, we're going to have Instagram and Facebook as the main center of focuses because it's a wide range of audience for a low cost. And merchandise will not be another essential part because we'll have the team colors that people will sport, such as red team can buy red shirts, can have red water bottles and really carry those themes through. And the promotion. So we are close to college campuses. We do want to make sure that sororities, fraternities, local churches, local businesses can all bring their teams there and interact together. And now I'll hand to Courtney for the after party.
Thank you, Angelina. I want to introduce to you the team. Spiked Up Fitness will be operated by our two motivating trainers, two friendly customer service staff members, and our general manager. We put a lot of research into creating a job description for our general manager that describes the essential responsibilities for this position, as well as the skills and experience we're looking for in potential candidates throughout the recruitment selection process. Next is our implementation plan. This is how we intend to aggressively market Spiked Up Fitness. The implementation plan goes through the first month of operations to month three, and it consists of two primary strategies that we feel are most efficient to meet our goals. The first strategy, our general manager and our trainers will be extremely active on social media, connecting with potential customers in our target market, putting out the Spiked Up Fitness name, Motivation Monday posts, nutrition advice. And our second strategy is our general manager will reach out to local businesses, establish a relationship with them, so that by the end of month three, we can meet our goal of having 12 official sponsors from those local businesses. So we can establish our coupon and benefits package for members of Spiked Up Fitness. Next is our business scorecard. And this will consist of four primary areas that will target our main goals. First are the financial goals. We will have a positive net profit, 83% growth at the end of year two. And the following year, we want to increase that growth to 20%. Next are our customer goals. By the end of year two, we intend to secure 150 memberships. The following year, bump up that membership number to 180. Internal process goals. This goes back to our implementation plan with those 12 secured sponsors, as well as at least 100 online reviews with an average of a 4-star rating. And last, people goals. If our employees are happy, our business will be productive. And we'll track this with employee satisfaction surveys, which our goal is to have an average of a 4 rating from 1 to 5 by the end of year two. And at the beginning of year three, employees will have the opportunity to receive bonuses based on the financial goals reached the previous year. This is used as an incentive to help increase membership sales. My partner, Aaron, will discuss the financials with you.
All right, so the fun financials. Let's jump into the income statement. I want to point out a couple things for you. The first column is our year one. Year one is our clients' sales from the initial year. And you can see in year two, our growth projected into year two, and then year three, which is that 20% growth margin. On the left-hand side, there's a couple items that have been changed, such as nutritional supplements. Those are our smoothie and our spiked smoothie sales. We also have our one-time classes, which is the $5 fee to come to our gym if you want to bring a friend. And then finally, merchandise, which is our gear, our cups, our shirts, and our team gear. And then we also have the gym monthly membership. I also want to point out a couple different changes to operating expenses, like the liquor license that we now have to pay for. Our labor costs has significantly increased, and then also our utility bill has significantly decreased. Moving forward into the cash flow statement, you have all about the same information above, and then below you can see the change in cash flows from the loan statement that we have been given. With me, I have Angelina Klosner and I have Courtney Craig. My name is Aaron Chichilla. This concludes our presentation. If there are any points that require further clarification, you can take those now. So with that included, those were the projected numbers from that 30% margin if you were to come into the gym.
So alcohol is part of your nutritional supplements?
We were given a nutritional supplements column, so we just carried that over. Instead of nutritional supplements, it's alcohol. Yeah, it's very expensive, especially in the St. Pete area.
For $1,500, you can purchase a liquor license?
Yes, a year.
You see, I'm guessing it's the proceeds that you pay around college times, right?
Yes.
What do you have to do with your plan? There's a seasonal and spring break happens, you're only targeting college students, and college students are gone, what happens to your loss?
I guess we could have some nice promotions for the elderly.
Yes. I'll take this question. So we're not just targeting college students, that is the bulk of students that are in the area is going to be that college age. I guess that's why we said students. But really, we're just trying to anyone from the ages of 18 to really 36. That seems to be the target market. At least through some of the analytics, it showed that that was the most densely populated in that area. So that would be our target audience.
Do you anticipate having challenges with your customer satisfaction? Because I noticed that you want an average of 4, but not until after your second year. So you anticipate struggles in that regard the first year?
We are doing something a little bit untraditional. So I would say that there's going to be a curve for people to adapt to some changes. But I think that this is something that nobody else is doing in our market. So it makes it completely stand out for us competitors. And I think a lot of businesses that we never thought before would become what they are now have become outrageous.
2 should be, I believe, 150, and then after that is 30 member increase, which is 180.
Okay. So is that where you're getting your...
The increase of the 20%?
Yeah.
Correct, but then it's also an increase in smoothie sales, because with that more members and the social interactions, you're going to have a little bit more of that.
And have you guys thought about, you know, just something to think about, you know, because normally when you work out, you feel good, probably don't want to drink. Although, I'm going to say I might be interested in that. But, what are your thoughts about, you know, how people might feel about going to get a drink? Because obviously the spike drinks are going to be more than the regular drinks. What's your dollar margin between those two? Because you're probably going to sell more of the non-spike drinks than the other ones.
Are you looking for pricing margins, or are you looking for
the pricing margin, like, well, how much money are you going to make with the spike drinks versus the non-spike?
So the material cost is about $3 per smoothie, and then we're selling about alcoholic ones above $8.
Okay.
So you're making about a $5 margin for your basic drink.
So it costs $3 to make a smoothie. It's $5 non-spike, $8 spike.
Correct. About. You're going to have variance in that, but correct.
Depending on the flavor and what type of alcohol you're putting in there, et cetera.
Okay. They only have access to the alcohol.
Yes. So this isn't a bar. This is a gym. And you are, after your workout, you are limited to one spiked smoothie per person. So people aren't going to be hanging out, getting drunk. And it's a very small amount of alcohol. It's just a little spike. And, It's just a little something after the workout that makes our gym unique. And I know the concept of alcohol and fitness is really weird to some people, but I run marathons. And I know beer culture is huge in marathons. At all the marathon events, you have all the beer stands out, and I personally really want a beer after running marathons, and some of my other friends do too. So it's actually not that weird of a concept. It's becoming increasingly popular to associate alcohol and fitness together. There's been some niche gyms on Facebook that have been going around, beer and yoga, yoga with goats. So this is one of those unique niche gyms that are especially going to appeal to our younger audiences that are looking for something different in their workout.
Well, did you want to ask if anybody else in the industry has done this connection?
Not for our research.
No. They've done one, which is part of it with this, the energy cycles as far as storing energy. And the team, they've done that, that's there. But the addition to having that smoothie bar with the spiked drinks and incorporating local businesses so that way it gets everyone together, no.
That's the end of the 5-minute question round. Let's give them a round of applause.
College of Social Marketing,
incorporating technology and fitness is the number one worldwide health trend of 2019. That is where we come in. Fusion Fitness is going to be the new innovative gym in downtown Orlando. Now, our mission statement is to show Orlando and Central Florida just how personalized gym workouts can be. While our vision statement is to provide gym users with 24/7 personalized experience through technology. A little background about our gym. When customers do purchase our tiered membership plan, which has three levels, they gain access to our Fusion Fit app, which can be downloaded on any smartphone. Now, what is special about this app is based on the three plans. The standard plan is $20 a month, and it allows the app to measure the customer's body weight and also body measurements to tailor a workout specifically designed for them every time they enter the gym. It will direct them to a piece of equipment and let them know exactly how long to use it or how many reps to complete before moving on to the next exercise. And after each exercise, it will measure their BPM to continuously tailor the workout for them depending on their current fitness level. This app is also not useless outside the gym, as our advanced plan, which is $30 a month, does have features like the ability to count steps, track activities that they do outside the gym, and also track their sleep patterns. Finally, our premium plan is only $5 more, $35 a month, and it does allow a wellness program, which does have a meal plan, which will recommend diets that also tracks the calories and macro and micronutrients that they do consume. The app also does allow for in-app purchases of our nutritional supplements that we do sell in-house, and also the ability to sync with wearable devices, which makes it easier for the consumer to actually complete their goals. We are going to be located in downtown Orlando. There's currently only one other gym in the area, so we do have a really great way to get out and reach a new market. Our target market is going to be 21 to 50 year olds who live or work within 8 miles of our location in downtown Orlando and have a personal income of $38,000 and also find it difficult to self-motivate in regards to fitness. Finally, for our marketing plan, we are going to be launching a Facebook ad campaign for 6 months between January and June, because this is the time when people are actually more interested in getting gym memberships because of year's resolutions and upcoming breaks like spring and summer breaks. We also do have a PR team that will be attending upcoming Orlando 5Ks and passing out promotional materials there. And we do have a sales promotion plan, where if a customer does buy a year membership in advance, they will receive $5 off each membership plan per month. Now, Caitlin is going to talk about our data analysis.
Thank you, Nicole. So after analyzing our data for the past year, we realized that we have a decreasing retention and revenue rate. And the reasons for this is long commuting times due to unfavorable locations, as well as no uniqueness or variety in workouts, and unmotivating environments at the gym. Our constraint was weather, and historically has been shown that less attendance has been at the gym when the weather is unfavorable. However, our top two membership programs allow special services that we can use outside of the gym when these arise, and so we can still maximize on the usage on those days. And when it comes to the balance scorecard, we will increase overall revenue by 170% in the first fiscal year, and we got these conversion rates from Facebook and our PR team. For income customers, we want to increase customer satisfaction by 20% for the first fiscal year. And this is just to make sure that we are satisfying our customers with our products and services. And internally, we want to have a 90% overall usage rate annually. And this is just to make sure that we are following suit with our business plan. And when it comes to the people, we want to ensure technical expertise of employees by implementing questionnaires and having a passing score of 95%. And this is just to make sure that our employees are helping our members as best as possible. When it comes to the elasticity of demand for our good, we have decided that it was a luxury good, and this is simply because as the income rises for our customers, so does the probability of them purchasing our gym memberships. For pest level analysis, we wanted to focus on IP protection for our Fusion Fitness app, and this is just to make sure that nobody is stealing our idea. When it comes to economic, there has been a steady increase in growth rate for the industry, and according to IBIS World, there has been a 1.1 increase, or there will be a 1.1 increase over the next 5 years. For sociocultural, with the recent health trends that have been happening, this will help with opportunities and endeavors in this industry. For technology, with the innovations that have been coming out, this this will decrease production costs, and this will have the overall decrease in the upkeep of our app. For legal, we want to focus on copyrights and patents to just ensure that nobody is using our app without our authorization. For environmental, we want to, with the push for the greener products, we want to be able to sell nutritional ingredients and products that are ADP and FDA and GMP approved. And with that, Charlene will discuss HR.
Thank you, Caitlin. So when it comes to the Human Resources Department, we're going to be focusing on our general manager. This individual, some of the responsibilities that they will have is, you know, looking over the enrollment for members, making sure that all the equipment is properly maintained, and making sure that if there's any discrepancies between either employees or even a customer, they'll be able to handle that as well. The salary that we are offering this individual is going to be $42,000 a year, as well as benefits such as portion of their health insurance covered, as well as 10 days of PTO. When it comes to the application process, we will be posting our application online on Monster.com as well as ZipRecruiters, because these two online job boards do provide and allow employers to post their applications for free. When it comes to the application itself, it's going to be a questionnaire formatted. It's going to be formatted as a questionnaire, and then the answers are going to be scored on a point value system. When it comes to the actual recruiting portion and the interviewing portion, it's going to be a pre-process interview. The first one is going to be a structural interview. Second one is going to be a behavioral interview, and the third portion of the interview is going to be a problem-solving interview portion. This is going to allow us to see the overall critical thinking as well as the analytical skills this individual may have. After we do have our top contenders, we will go over the references that were provided to us in the application. And once we do have our top contender, we will call them and offer them the general manager position. Once that is done, we will begin discussing the recruitment process for the remainder of the employees for our Fitness Fusion gym. Moving forward, Antoine will go over the financial projections.
Thank you, Charlene. So, according to Ivy's World, the industry growth for the gym, fitness, and health service clubs in the U.S. is 1.1%. Now, that's what we based our total sales of $190,000 roughly for the fiscal year. With that being said, where did we get that number from? It's pretty high. Facebook ads. So we did a mock-up between January and June, as stated before, that said we will engage with at least 170 guests per day, meaning over the 6 month span, it's going to be about 30,000 people we'll engage with online. Meaning with a conversion rate of 4.8%, we're gonna have roughly 1,500 guests that will sign up for our gym membership alone between January and June. Now, our base price is $30, it's mid-tier, but they also have a startup cost of about $35. And again, that goes back all together to tie into where we get our fiscal year sales of $190,000. Moving on to profit margin, in the beginning, year one started out pretty low, $66,000, negative net profit, already a bad idea. Expenses kind of on the mid-side, but the profit margin was negative 22%. But for year two, we're thinking optimistic. $190 worth of sales, net profit $37,000, and our expenses are a little higher because we want to include the research and development portion for the app development for Fusion Fit. And with that and sales combined, we'll have profit margins of about 20%. Now the difference from year one to year two, negative and positive. It's simple, 20%, well 42%, but the biggest difference is our sales revenue is definitely going to hike about three times. 188% sales growth is what we're expecting. Now, moving forward to implementation, it's pretty simple. With the app, we plan on creating the app for the first 3 months. The next 3 months, we're going to implement the app into our workout plans. And then for the last 6 months, we're going to take customer feedback and app usage and just revise and update the app so that it works out for the business. Now, with that, in conclusion, I want to say I thank you guys for listening. We are AI Consulting, and at this time, I'm going to open up the floor for questions, and we're going to keep our answers brief so everyone has a chance to answer. Thank you.
Yes, I just want to make sure I'm understanding it. So your entire gym basis is based off of the app, so that's why there's
no trainers or anything. You just have one person running the gym, and it's kind of like you are the one paying to just go and use the equipment via your admin as your trainer.
We also have employees, like you have the help desk that will be there to help you with questions, but we also have people walking around in assistance with the technological aspect of the app, and if you need any questions with the actual machines.
Right, but they're not trainers at all, they're just working with the app. And what are the titles of these folks?
The top, I mean, is just going to be the app specialist,
okay,
would be the title, and it's going to be based, once we hire our general manager, we'll discuss with him on how he actually wants to do the staffing, which we'll keep them at minimum wage, which is about $9 now, and they can have to be part-time and full-time.
Can you go back to the projected expense growing sales? So, from year one to year two, from an expense standpoint, from $54,000 to about $70,000.
Yes.
What, out of that bucket, what is your biggest expense coming out of that?
The expense of the research and development for the app. So it's about roughly $15,000 to $20,000 that we're going to initially put in to have someone to develop the app, essentially. Okay.
So you guys factor in from a rent and lease perspective in a downtown location?
We did do some research on increasing rent. The rent's going to increase by about $1,500 from year one to year two, so that was just a small increase of the rent that we did factor in with our expenses. What was the monthly rent? It was on the assumption that we did. I cannot remember on top of my head, but I don't want to give you an incorrect number.
Can you go to the next slide just for 1 second? Okay, so we're creating the fitness app, and then you're going to implement it. Can you just go through that one more time for me? Because I took away from it that the gym was going to be open before the app was complete. Is that accurate or no?
Meaning that the once the app is developed, then we're going to open up.
Okay, so the app.
Yes. Okay. This was just our.
I just wanted to make sure that I understood that. Yeah. We're focusing on the app and not ready for the gym open. I don't know what they're going to get.
What's that whole timeline?
The whole timeline is 12 months. So 3 months for the creation, then we'll be open the gym. Another 3 months for the implementation phase, where we're going to be implementing all the features, and then the 6 months for reviewing and from customer feedback, if we need to add new features or update the app, which we have in year two, another $8,000 put aside for any revisions that we need to do.
I saw that there was cost to use the app. Was that the gym membership cost, or is that the app cost? Are they unique, or are they separate items?
We have a initial startup fee of $35 regardless of, and then we have the $20 and $30 and $35 monthly fee for using the app, and depending on the features that are added to it.
Exactly.
Yes,
sir. Could you expand a little bit on the promotion, the marketing piece you were talking about with Facebook?
Yeah, so basically, we did a mock-up, with a budget of about $1,500 to $2,000, and it gave us rough estimate numbers on basically how many people we would reach. So we kind of ran, we didn't run with it, but from our research, we just put out that this is how many people that we'll be reaching, and it gave us a conversion rate, so that would be the people initially that would just sign up for our gym, and that's kind of how we got there. So the marketing campaign is mostly Facebook, and we also have like the Orlando 5Ks, the different 5Ks around the city. That's gonna help for our marketing piece. That way we're kind of like have a face-to-face and not just social media.
In regards to the career development for the gym, my first question in regards to that is $42K, where did you get that number?
So we did do some research, and like other teams have mentioned, it is roughly $36,000, $38,000. We just decided to do a little bit more because of the requirements that we are asking. We are asking for previous experience, and then with $42,000, it is a very competitive wage. So
for someone to run a gym.
Yes.
So the average nationally right now is $38,000 for general managers. We put up a little bit because we do want them to have some expertise also in the technical side of it, so it is a little competitive, and we also do have benefits that they can have and also that we are offering.
So what's their career growth? They didn't hear about where they can go from there. So this is what they can do, they're just GMs.
The career growth right now is just to be a GM. As we do expand, we are looking to be a franchise to other cities also, so we also have maybe opportunities for them to work in those other cities or when we do expand higher, but this is just for the initial phase.
And what's the qualification for you? Educated, experience.
So we are looking for the college educated for at least 2 years experience. experience in the gym and fitness area, and also to have some technical expertise, like a certificate for actually marketing.
Okay. That's the end of the 5-minute question period.